Hey everyone, it's Deja from crocheteverafter.com. Today is the newest motif of the month. It's November 2014, and this is, I'm calling it a bicycle wheel motif, because it just reminds me of like spokes on a bicycle, so that's what I'm naming this guy. We are using some worsted weight yarn. This one's Karen Simply Soft, so I haven't used this one in a while, so I picked some up while I was at the store the other day, and I really like the colors, and it is very soft. So this is, let me see what color these. This is blue mint and autumn red, kind of a pretty combination. And I'm using a 5mm H hook, which gives me nice stitch definition. So grab your yarn, your hook, and download the pattern below, and let's get started. Okay, so to begin our bicycle wheel motif, what we're gonna do is put a slip knot on our hook. So if you haven't done a slip knot before, you kind of hold both yarn, or your two ends of your yarn, as a loop in both your hands, and just turn down the loop, or the hand that has the loop. And then you can reach through there and grab your working yarn, the yarn attached to your ball, not your tail, and pull that through. And then just tighten it down, and now you have a sliding slip knot. So put your hook on that and pull the tail, oops, that's attached to your yarn, to close it down. Now we're ready to begin. So we're going to do a chain six, and then we're going to join it with a slip stitch. So chain, we always yarn over from back to front. I forgot what that was called. And I always point my hook down to pull through, because it gets me through my chains a lot easier. And I just keep my chains the size of the shaft of my hook. So when I finish my chain, I push my loop to my shaft to keep it the same size, so every time you'll see me push to the shaft. And then I have six. So I'm going to join this round with a slip stitch in the first chain I made. So you can count backwards six, or you can just go right to that very first chain. I'm going to insert my hook in there, and it doesn't matter where, because this whole round is going to get covered up by, or this whole circle is going to get covered up by round one, because this technically is not a round yet. I'm going to lay over my yarn, it just kind of goes right over the top of my hook. I turn my hook to kind of catch it and pull through. And then I pull through the other loop on my hook, and that's my slip stitch. So now we have a nice sized hole in the center for the beginning of our bicycle wheel. Okay, so now to begin round one, what we're going to do is chain three, and that's going to count as a double crochet. I just yarn over and pull through three times. And then I'm going to do 11 double crochets all the way around to make a big ring inside the ring that I just made. So I yarn over from back to front. They're always, all of your yarn overs will always be back to front. I insert my hook through the center of my ring. You just kind of get your tail out of the way there. Push it through. Then I yarn over, but it's more of like a layover. It just kind of lays over the top of your hook. Turn it down a little bit to catch it and pull it through. Then you're going to yarn over from back to front. And the double crochet we do by pulling through the first two loops and then pushing your hook to your shaft to get nice even stitches. Yarn over and pull through the second two. Push to your shaft to get a nice even stitch. So that's your very first double crochet. You can these slide on the ring, so you can always just move them over if you're running out of room when you start making all of these. But again, I'm going to yarn over back to front. Hook through the center, grab my yarn, pull it up, yarn over, pull through the first two, push to the shaft, yarn over, pull through the second two, push to the shaft. So you'll notice if I do this in regular time, I'm always pushing to my shaft after every single step that I do. And that gives me nice even stitches that are all the same height. So if you have a problem with your stitches going up and down like this, it might be because you're kind of pulling. If you pull up your loops a lot when you're doing your, I'm doing a crazy style. If you pull up your loops a lot when you're doing your stitches, which is not wrong, you can do it that way. You can see I have a really tall double crochet now. But if I do that every single stitch, sometimes you may not pull it up the same height every time. So if you find that your stitches are a little wavy looking, that could be the reason. So if you like the look of, you know, the even stitches, then just make sure that you're using your shaft to make your loops. That's what makes the size of each loop the same, so you get those even stitches. So I'm going to keep going around. I'm going to do 11 double crochets, and the chain 3 counts as my very first double crochet, which is going to give me 12 total. And then we'll join it up at the end of the round. Okay, I just finished my 12th double crochet. If you're not used to counting your stitches, it can be a little difficult to see the fronts of your stitches. You may not be used to seeing those. So remember, you can always turn your work sideways and count the tops of your stitches, which look like the letter V. So it's like a V stacked on top of a V all the way down. So it also looks like a foundation chain. So you'll see that when you make your foundation chain, it looks like that. So you can just count those. You can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 8. Oops. Miscounted. I lost one while I was counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I did miss one completely because I only have 11. Good thing I counted, so I need to make one more for 12. Alright, so now I have 11 double crochets and one chain 3, so that counts as one of my stitches. Okay, so now that I have 12, good thing I counted, I'm going to join my round with a slip stitch in the top of my chain 3. So I have 1, 2, and 3, so I'm going to insert my hook right in there. I'm going to yarn over and pull that through and pull through the loop on my hook. So now I have a round of 12 double crochets all the way around with a nice big hole in the middle. So now it's time for round 2. So the first thing that we're going to do is chain 5. And the chain 5 is going to count as a double crochet and a chain 2. Because normally in crochet, a chain 3 will count as a double crochet. So it's a double crochet and then a chain 2 turning sideways, which is usually going to create like a space in between our stitches. So then we're going to double crochet in our next stitch. So this chain 3 is where we slip stitch, and that's counting as our very first stitch. But now we're going to double crochet into the next stitch. So what you can do, if you're having trouble finding where to go, turn it sideways and look for your stitches. So yarn over, insert your hook under just the top two loops. So if you do this, you shouldn't be able to see any other yarn. If you've gone too low and caught like a third loop, you'll see I have 1, 2, and there's one over here. I'm trying to show you. There we go. You can see 3 now. So if you have that middle, you went too far. Go back and just catch those top two loops. Then yarn over, pull up your loop, pull through the first two, and pull through the second two. Then we're going to chain 2, and we're going to repeat that. We're going to go double crochet into the next stitch. So we're doing a double crochet in every stitch around, but we're putting a chain 2 between each one, and this is kind of like the spokes of the bicycle wheel. So we're going to keep going all the way around with these. I'm doing my last double crochet of the round, and then I'm going to chain 2 one more time, because this beginning chain 2 of the chain 5 that we started with is the space between this double crochet and that double crochet. So I have to create the space between the last one and the first one now. So I'm going to join, but where I'm going to join matters, so make sure that you can count your chains, because we want to join in the top or the third chain from the bottom, because we need those two chains for our space, so we're not joining all the way over here. So you got to count up 1, 2, and 3 and join there. So it's like joining at the top of a double crochet. We slip stitch that, and then we're going to fasten off this color. So I do like a little chain and I pull it really long to cut a tail. And then we're going to join in our other color for the final round, which is like our tire wheel. Alright, I got my new color, this pretty blue, and we're going to join with what's called a standing stitch. So it's kind of like just starting your first stitch without having to join with a slip stitch. So you're going to put a slip knot on your hook. Then instead, so this is what you would normally do. You would go, we're going to join at a double crochet, so pick any of the double crochets around, and you're going to join in the top two loops of one of those stitches. So a normal join would be a slip stitch join. So you would yarn over, pull it through, pull through the loop on your hook, tighten that down because you're just joining. Then you would chain one, and then you would single crochet into that stitch. And you get a big old blob of stuff. So a standing stitch instead, let me keep my slip knot here, we're just going to start making our stitch. So we're going to go under both loops, yarn over, pull up our loop, keep them close together, don't like pull them all the way out here, keep them nice and close to your stitch, yarn over, and pull through both. And you just made a single crochet. So the only difference is your tail, where it comes out, is at the top of your stitch instead of right next to here, but that doesn't matter when you weave it in. It's still not going to be visible. So this whole round is just going to be single crochet. So we're going to do two single crochets around the chain two space. So two to take up two. Then we're going to do a single crochet in our double crochet. In those top two loops. And that's what we're going to do all the way around. So then we're going to go two in the chain, one in the double crochet. Nice and easy. So keep doing your single crochets all the way around, and then we'll meet up at the end to join, fasten off, and weave in ends. And back to you before the end of the round, just so I could show you how to work into the slip stitch, or the that ending round that we did of round two. So when you're going in, you can see that big hole right there. Just go right into that big hole. You're going to kind of cover up the slip stitch and everything else that happened there, and it's going to mask it. Now you can start, you can see it's kind of popping in the back there, so we'll just kind of pull on that to get it the stitch closer. Pull that out again. Because sometimes the fasten off, it creates that little bubble where you knot it kind of with that fasten off. So just make sure your stitch is kind of covering right over that. That's a little bit better. Then if you want, you can start crocheting around your tail. Otherwise you can just leave it out to weave it in at the end. But you can start doing that, and then you can just weave it in from wherever you leave it off. So I'll leave it off right there so I can go straight into this stitch here to weave in. So on my last chain two, remember we started in a double crochet. So now we're going to join up with a slip stitch. So it's nice and easy. We have our first single crochet, just go under both those loops, yarn over, pull through, and fasten off. So now we just need to weave in our ends. So when you've got a small amount of color like this blue, you want to be careful weaving in your ends because you don't want to end up in the red and having it peek through. So to hide this little fasten off bubble that we have, usually what you can do is go into the next stitch right in the middle of it and pull. You'll kind of lay it over so it's not as visible. Then I'm going to go to the back side of the project so you can tell the front from the back. The front has the nice stitches on top, the nice V's. When you flip it over, you can see that you can see more of the red through this side. So we use this side to weave in. So I'm going to keep going in the direction that I was going, and I'm going to try to get through. You can go right through the middle of stitches, it doesn't matter, but I'm going to try to go back and forth, up and down. If this is going to be a dual-sided project, then you're going to want to make sure that this is really nice. So if it's going to be like a shawl with a bunch of circles put together, or a scarf with a bunch of circles put together, oops, what I did there, don't do that. Then you want to take a lot of time weaving in the end, so that's definitely not visible from either side. You can see I'm not coming through the chain stitch up here because that's visible from the front, so I'm sticking to these stitches down over here. So once you get it woven in enough that you're comfortable, then you're going to cut that off and do the rest. So the red That center one's easy because you have all these nice thick stitches. But this red, we don't have. We have big gaps in between our stitches. So you want to get to the nice thick stitches to weave in this end. So to do that, I'm going to go right down the center of this double crochet. In and out, in and out. And now I am to that nice thick area where I can hide my stitches much easier. So I'm going to go in and out, back and forth. The more times you go in and the more times you go back and forth, the securer it will be. So I'm going to do these last two and then we'll come back and check it out. Alright, we got the bicycle wheel complete and it's all woven in. So this type of motif you can make in like really big chunky yarn or really small yarn. What could be cool is if you did that, use chunky yarn, try to find like maybe a red heart, or Knit Picks is a good one because they have the Brava bulky and the Brava worsted and the palette. You could make a bunch of different colors and the different sizes and then connect them all in crazy way to make a scarf or a shawl. That could be really pretty. But you can use this for like an applique. It could be kind of the type of flower I'm thinking of, but it could be, you know, anything. You could make wheels and do a little bicycle, whatever you want. But this is the motif of the month for November 2014, and thank you for watching.